Morning, good afternoon, good evening to my beautiful people. It's Casey Brown TV Show. If it's your first time here, please don't forget to subscribe. Don't forget to leave your hand on the notification bell for more videos and updates, so that anytime I drop videos, you'll be first person to be notified so that you can come around and grab new updates. Here we talk about migrants and document issue. You want to know more about, you know, as a migrant, as a foreigner in this country, we need to be, you know, bringing updates about what is happening around us as document issues. You know, that's the main thing that many people are fighting, are willing to get. You know, that's the main thing people are, you know, want to be hearing for, and YouTubers like us. So people who are doing the same as I'm doing, you know, talking about document, saying things about the migrants, you people need to be connected to those channels. You people need to, you know, subscribe, you know, following them, and, you know, giving them more, you know, encouragement to be bringing more updates, so that you guys can be knowing what is happening around us. Understand? So I know many things are happening with, you know, between, you know, bloggers and YouTubers. You know, sometimes I used to see small videos around, but we need to, you know, embrace love. Love is the best thing that we need to do. Understand? As a black and as an African, you know, we are fighting about Black's life matter. So we need to, you know, show it between ourselves, you know, by embracing love first. As a black people, we need to love ourselves as a black people. We don't need to, you know, fighting ourselves. Understand? We don't need to be, you know, haunting ourselves or, you know, treating our brothers or sisters bad. We need to show ourselves self-love before people can be or another foreigners or other people can, you know, can show love to us back. So we need to show love to ourselves first. So let's go back to the, you know, document issue. What is happening, you know? This Sanatoria, the government are planning to give, or are saying that the estimate of people who can obtain these documents, you know, that estimate, they say 220,000 people can obtain this Sanatoria, you know, the Sanatoria that they opened on the 1st of June. So, but something did not go according to the government plan. But something did not go according to the government plan, as told by the AGI. Understand? As of June 5, unofficial data speak of 9,500 applications submitted. As of June 5, unofficial data speak of 9,500 applications submitted, well below the number estimated by the government by July 15, the closing date of the deadlines. You know, since on the first day this time, they're saying that it's only 9,500 applications have been submitted. Understand? According to the plans of the government, the estimated plans that they're saying that the people who can obtain this document, they were talking about 220,000 people. But people who have submitted the application, it's only 9,500 people. Understand? That is what they are saying. There is still time. It is true, but the first sign are not positive. There is still time, but the first sign are not positive. Mostly of these 9,500 people who have submitted that application, many of those people are not, they might not be approved. They will not accept their proposal because many of them are not positive. Yet, Bellanova does not give up so much. Bellanova, that is the Minister of Agriculture, she does not give up so much. She don't want to give up because anything that the Questura or the Prefetura are doing, they are passing it to the Minister of Agriculture, the Minister of Interior. So they can be knowing the people, the estimate people that said I want to give document is 220,000. But people who are applying for this Sanatoria right now is only 9,500 people. And most of those people, the document that they submitted are not positive. Something went wrong. Understand? So Bellanova does not give up, she said. But she said that according to the first data is successful. That is, she won the Sanatoria. That is a successful one. Moreover, we understand the need to transform a flop. Flop means failure. Many parties are saying that this Sanatoria is a failure. Understand? It's a failure because things are not going accordingly. But Bellanova does not give up. At least, according to the first data, it should not be forgotten that Italia Viva, the party led by Matteo Renzi, and of which Bellanova is a member, had threatened the government crisis to get the measures approved, which was then included in the relaunch decree. Before they approved this senatorial, was a big fight, a big battle. We know about it. She cried about it. Understand? She even threatened to resign if the government did not approve the senatorial. But now they have approved the senatorial, but things are not working the way they were planning it. Understand? Because they were putting almost 220,000 people to obtain this document, but the people who are applying for this document, these are senatorial, is going slowly. Understand? So, the rules build conditions for social justice. The rules build conditions for social justice. Whatsoever the result, it will never be a flop. Bellanova say, whatsoever the result, it will never be a flop. It will never be a failure. Even if only one person was torn from invisibility and working in a good condition, it still consider it a successful one. If it's only one person, can obtain this document, it's a successful one for her. She has removed that person from the mafias. She has removed the person as irregular migrant. She has removed that person to become, a regular person, a person that been known, the person can assess for better people. If it's only 20,000, 50,000, 200, or 200,000, 50,000 obtain this document, it's a successful one for her, for removing invisibility people from the street. Many people are living in a former settlement, in ghettos, forcing them to work. If it's all of those people or any of those people obtain documents from the street, it's a better and a successful one for her. And it's a good one also. My brother, my sister, as you know, it's a good one. I give her a very big clap for her because she's very intelligent. If it's only one person can obtain documents from the sanatorium, it's a big successful one for her to remove that person from the street, from the ghetto, from being invisibility, to be a real and regular person. The person can work in a good condition. The person can, transform his life or her life to a better one. Understand? But Bellanova know that there will still other immigrants working as a black work, as a without no document, as irregular workers who are working in different sectors also. There are many people who are working in different sectors without no documents. But she said gradually she's going to bring that topic out in their next meeting. So let's be praying. Many people are being, complaining. It's only these farmers, agriculture, domestic workers, they pass the law to them, but the other people are working fabric companies, construction, different sectors. Why are they not among? But the fault for the farmers, because those farmers are the people who are, bringing food, they bringing fruit and vegetables. They are the one bringing food in this crisis that we are, this corona crisis. There are the people who are working, and people who are, these are domestic workers, are people who are cleaning and doing cleaning in different sectors, taking care of old people, children, which their fathers or their parents, their children are going to work. So they need people to stay with their fathers, their mothers, their old people at home. So that's why they passed this law first. But she knew that they have a lot of people working in different sectors, but everything will be gradually. So let's pray for a better one and a better plan for the, migrants. And many couples are not, following the rules. Many of them don't want to sign contracts with people. That's the big thing. That's why this application is going slowly, because many of them don't want to sign contract, many of them don't want to pay taxes, many of them don't want to pay contribution. So that is it. That is what is happening. And many of them are submitting fake, contract also. So my brother said, we need to be careful. So that's why they put those measures, that if your boss or your capo don't have 30,000 as agriculture or 20,000 as a domestic workers, they cannot approve the sanatoria for the people, for the, you know, the workers. They need to prove that they are paying tax. They need to know that these people are working, and they are working and they are paying their workers. That's why they put those measures, those 30,000 and those 20,000. So that's why they put it. They know many fake contracts will be there. So many investigators, many people are investigating this contract, investigating the code or the ready to that the bulls or the capo are submitted. They are investigating this, and they are seeing many fake ones. So that's why these things are going slowly, and that's why they say there's only 9,500. Isn't that inside that 9,500 people, they are still seeing negative things. Many of them are not, you know, positive. That's what they're saying. So, but Bellanova said that there is still hope, there is still time, there is time till next month 15, things can change. So let's be hopeful, let's be prayerful, understand, because they placed 220,000 people who can obtain this document, but now they are saying this people the thing are going, these are sanctuary is going slowly. But she says she will never give up. If only one person can obtain documents from this sanatorium, it's a big successful, you know, project for her. It's a big one for her to remove that person from the ghetto, from the hand of the mafians, so the person can be regular to work as a regular person, for the person to better he or her lives. So that is a better word. So please, my brothers and sisters, let's be prayerful, let's show love to one another. Please, my brother and sister, please like this video and share this video to your friends and our families, so people can see many what is going on in the sanitarian, you know, issues. So my brother and sister, see you in my next video, and stay tuned and stay connected to this program. Please, my brother and sisters, my black Africans, let's embrace love. One love to my brother and sisters. Please stay safe and stay blessed. Bye for now. See you in my next video. It's Casey Brown TV Show. Bye.